from a windy warehouse on the shores of Lake Ontario to an innovative university exploring how tech could help build more homes faster and more affordably, one game-changing meeting between Canada's housing agency and one of the country's leading housing providers kickstarted a first-of-its-kind project. 3D printed homes.
In Windsor and Essex County, there's 6,500 families on a waiting list for our community subsidized housing. We know that there's an additional about 4,000 families that are about one paycheck away from losing their housing stability. So how the project came about, the University of Windsor was working on research. There were printers that really wanted to build houses, and CMHC was a funder of funding innovation. And Habitat for Humanity is known for providing safe, decent, affordable housing. So together, I believe all three of those groups were going to achieve the outcomes that CMHC wanted.
We had been exploring innovations in the construction industry that could bring more affordable units to the market cheaper and faster. We identified 3D construction printing as an opportunity. We raised it during a call with Habitat, and they loved the idea. The University of Windsor had also been following the progress of 3D printing around the world for about 3 years. So together, we agreed to examine it more closely.
This project funded by CMHC gave the student the opportunity to apply their technical and managerial skill in a real wall construction. I'm thankful to CMHC.
Habitat for Humanity and the University of Windsor submitted proposals to CMHC for the research and development of a 4-unit 3D printed development. When the proposals were approved, Habitat assumed the role of project lead, and the university began searching for a company with a printer large enough to 3D print 4 houses.
Nidus 3D is Canada's leading construction printing company. We do 3D construction printing where we use the big machine that you can see right behind me to stack layers of concrete to build housing. We're using a standard construction material, the structural concrete that we use, and we're just deploying it in a new way. We got a call out of the blue from Habitat Windsor-Essex, from Fiona. She messaged me on LinkedIn and said, hey, could you guys come in and print something? And it was about 3 months earlier than we'd intended to really print anything outside of a warehouse sort of testing setting. So we kind of accelerated a lot of stuff very, very quickly and got the equipment down to Windsor.
Under the guidance of Dr. Srikanta Das, Professor of Civil Engineering at the University of Windsor, a team of 3 students was formed. Together, they led on-site research and testing, assisted with on-site project management, and coordinated the design and printing of the 3D files. But one question remained.
Where are we going to put these houses?
Nestled on the northern shores of Lake Erie, the town of Leamington has a population of almost 30,000. This number fluctuates throughout the year and peaks during the summer months as temporary workers arrive to support the town's massive agricultural sector.
I knew that they had enough infrastructure in this town to support the effort that needed to come together to make this development happen.
Having previously worked with Habitat on several housing developments, Mayor Hilda MacDonald was keen to create more affordable housing. She connected Fiona with the Bridge Youth Resource Centre.
They knew of our organization and that we were looking to build homes and that we had the land to do so, and so the connection happened from there.
In many ways, the Leamington project was an ideal site for printing, and especially one of our first projects. It was large, there was a lot of laydown area. The equipment is very, very big, and even just moving it off the trucks and having enough room to place it somewhere prior to assembly is really important.
In close collaboration with Nidus 3D, the university researchers printed samples in identical conditions to the building and took them back to the lab for testing.
University of Windsor has one of the largest structural testing lab in Canada, and this has allowed us testing full-scale load test on the wall and other structural components printed in the side.
They came back and said, you can park 90 cars on that house because that's how much pressure the wall could take.
As the building took shape, the bridge prepared to take on a new role as landlords of Canada's first multi-unit 3D printed homes.
We put together an application form and we had a committee go ahead and select those that were going to be successful in their tenancies here.
Lou and Tammy Malotte had been following the development on local news. A cancer diagnosis left Lou unable to work, and the stress of maintaining a home forced them to sell and look for a more manageable alternative.
Compared to the cost of owning a home,
yeah,
and now renting here, it is a lot easier.
For me, just to have a shower or a bath before was a big problem. So I had to step over the tub and everything. I fell and I banged my head and stuff like this. So now it's all level, so the shower is better. It gives me a chance to just concentrate on the fight, you know, because you do fight.
This incredible project has transformed the housing outcomes for its residents. It has also helped to reshape the conversation around residential construction.
The challenges that the construction sector are facing are enormous. And so any technology that begins to address those sort of challenges through some partial automation, like what the 3D printer does, through consolidating fabrication in centralized locations like modular does, all of these, I think, are going to play a role.
The data we gathered through the testing, full-scale testing of the structural specimen printed, and also the knowledge we learned from the housing project in Leamington will help us developing various future design standard and the code like ASTM and ISO. That will help us designing and building the future 3D printed house.
I think the nice thing about Habitat for Humanity is that we work to address the needs in our unique communities. This becomes part of Habitat's toolkit that could be used across the country.
What the partners achieve on this project is incredible. They've set the stage for further development of 3D construction printing as a housing solution. True housing innovation.